The massed bands of all five bands under the leadership of Dave Milstead. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. A couple of questions spring to mind. Firstly, why do they put the microphone so far away? Secondly, why is a woodwind player conducting a brass band? Right, for those of you who don't know me, I'm David Milstead. I'm a woodwind specialist, but that's my day job. My real job for the last 40 years has been a low brass player, mainly on the E flat bass, but dabbling with B flat, trombone, euphonium. Starting in the St Albans City Band 40 years ago. My God, 40 years ago. I was three. Anyway, now, that piece that we just played was Castle Coch, which It's a castle somewhere in Wales. It looks fairly spectacular when you look at it, so it's well worth a visit. The next piece we're going to do is Farandole. Just checking. Farandole from George Bizet's L'Arlésienne Suite, one of his suites. And a farandole is a French dance popular in Provence. Now, if you wish to know how to do the dance, are you all right? I thought it was signaling to me. If you want to know how to do a farandole, it's quite simple. It's two hops on one leg, then two hops on the other. I will demonstrate. I can find a flat bit. If you wish to try it, be careful, find a flat bit of grass, and it's in the fast bit. You'll know the fast bit because it goes quick. Okay? So, there you are. So if you want to bring a smile to the band's faces, do have a go at it. So remember, start on whichever leg you like, but it's too hot. If you've been at the beer tent, don't try it, especially if you're holding one. Okay. So here we are, the farandole from Bizet's L'Arlésienne Suite. Did anyone try that? I couldn't see, I was following them. No, nobody out of breath, okay. Well, we're going from one dance to another dance. Now, this dance, this song, this dance, the words for the song, these were all the creation of Katie Moss. Not Kate Moss, but Katie Moss, who in the 19th century visited the Cornish village of Helston. And according to the diary that she wrote on the train on the way back, she witnessed this display of revelry, of singing and dancing. And she felt quite sad because she knew nobody that she could see who would dance with her. And so she felt very out of things. But then, aha, she spies a young man approaching her that she recognised, at least that's what she said, who then took her on the merry dance, in and out of houses, and they had a really, really fun time. Now, this song was made very popular in the 1970s by the late, great Terry Wogan. Did it go to number one? And it was accompanied, it wasn't by the Grimethorpe, Corey, who was it? The Brighouse and Rastrick Band. You didn't play with them, did you? No. Shame. Right, anyway, this is the floral dance, or as it properly should be known, is the furry dance. So there. Where's Christian? We're about to play your piece, mate. Just like I say, we haven't played it before. I haven't conducted it before, and he hasn't heard it yet. So it's a treat for all of us. No, it's going to be wonderful. Okay. Right, you ready for this? Okay.
Thank you.
The writing of the piece. So Steve Driver, thank you very much indeed. Thank you. On with the programme.
That's slightly scary. Excellent piece. I mean, we thoroughly enjoyed working on that, playing it. It's the first time we've all got together to do that. It's a real credit to that young man. We're now going to move on to something slightly different. It's a piece called Aces High. It wasn't originally called Aces High, it was called the Luftwaffe March. And it was from the film The Battle of Britain, and written by the, well, he is immortal now because he's dead, Ron Goodwin, who's very famous for pieces of music such as Those Magnificent Men in Their Flying Machines and Where Eagles Dare, and even Mr. Sheen advert. He wrote the music for Mr. Sheen Cleans or whatever. I don't know. Those of you who remember that. I used to use it. Anyway, Aces High.
Thank you.
Now, every self-respecting brass band will have a hymn book of especially arranged hymns. They're usually fairly standard because brass bands are almost always called upon to accompany services on special occasions, and you need to have all the hymns. And they're also a really good way of warming up. So we're just going to give you a little bit of Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven. If you know the words, we're doing verses 1 and 4. We have come to the final of the finale, the end of today. Please don't shout for more at the end because we haven't got another one. If you look sort of behind you, you will see a lone drummer who said to me earlier, please don't make them look at me. So I said, all right, I won't do that. He is going to introduce us into a piece called Highland Cathedral. This is a piece I've conducted on many occasions, but never with this band behind me. I have been lucky enough to conduct it in the Symphony Hall, Birmingham, with half a dozen pipers and the massed bands, and it is just spine tingling. Now, I have a feeling the hairs are going to go up on my arms and everywhere when I conduct it here. And as soon as I've finished, Jock is going to just start. Thank you.
staying all the day. David, thank you very, very much. All of you, thank you for staying. That was a fantastic performance. Thank you very, very much. Wonderful day. Thank you.